all the people have been to New Zealand, and they all wish that they were here. No, obviously they do, and I'm very, very glad that I am here. And I really like to praise the Lord. Back in 89, I wanted to do something different, change my life, went overseas, came back. I was brought up in Canberra, so I went back to Canberra. Go to the Canberra Raiders. Robbies! And everyone was doing what they always did and what I had always been doing. That was drinking, smoking, and smoking marijuana. And I didn't want to do that anymore. So, and I tried to give up all those things, but in my own strength, I'm a very weak person. So I went to, got this body to go to Adelaide, so off I go, visit my sister in a little town called Dunedoo, get on a bus to Dubbo, from Dubbo to Adelaide, get off the bus and go, what am I going to do now? Where am I going to stay? Don't know anyone, but anyway. I got to, someone said about the YWCA, so I stayed there, and I'd already booked one of those Harndorf tours, little German town just outside of Adelaide. And someone stopped me in the street, when I was in Handel, someone stopped me in the street and said, have you heard about the Day of Pentecost? And I went, nah, what's that? And it was a Sunday. And him and this lady said, do you want to come to a meeting? I went to a meeting. The pastor gave a talk at this meeting. And he just kept mentioning the Holy Spirit. And I just said, well, what's this? I said to him, what's this Holy Spirit thing he's talking about? What's that all about? And she said, oh, do you want to go for prayer? And I went, oh, yeah, I'll go for prayer. So I went up for prayer. And then, yeah, it was all pretty casual. I was pretty, a bit too casual off you. But anyway, she said, do you want to get baptised? And I went, yeah, I'll give that a go. So I got baptised by full immersion, and just like they showed me in the Bible. And then didn't receive the Holy Spirit that day, but 2 days later, I knew there was a meeting on the Tuesday. I knew there was a meeting, so I threw away my cigarettes that morning, and no one said you shouldn't drink, smoke or whatever. I just threw them away. I was going on a Barossa Wine Valley tour. You know, you go down to the stores and try some wine. And I went on that tour, and I didn't drink any wine, but for the first time, I actually saw the landscape. So how beautiful it was, and just look at what God did. But that night, I went in and I received the Holy Spirit, and I know that because I spoke in tongues. And you know, people say being in the Lord's a journey. You know what? I reckon it's an adventure. I've had some amazing adventures being in the Lord. I also had bad nicotine stains on my fingers, and the Lord took them away a week later. I was going to do that, I don't know, a couple of housewifing tasks where you rub lemon and all that. Well, I didn't do that because I looked down at my fingers and the nicotine stain was gone. He gave me a job. I actually worked in a mental hospital as a cleaner, because I'm trained at nothing. And one of the worst wards is where everything was plastic. They had this old heavy-duty space invaders machine, if you remember them, because it's so heavy they couldn't pick it up and throw it. Well, 2004, I went into that ward to clean it, and this girl had been abusing me for 2 days in a row. And I was, and on the third morning, I was just about to unlock the door, and I just said, I'm a person of believing God. This shouldn't come to me, Lord, you've got to protect me. And you know what? She couldn't, that third day, this girl could not get out of her way quick enough for me. And so it kind of turned around. Last year, we had a couple of things hanging over our heads, as in there's a court case hanging over our head, been going on for about a year, and I just had a little prayer and fast on a Monday morning, and about 11:30 that day, because we were supposed to go to court that week on the Thursday, my husband ran up and said, I'm not going to believe this, court case, we're going to have to go to court, it's all cleared up, you know, so that was amazing. If anyone knows me, they know I like to walk. And so I went on a holiday to Tasmania, took with a couple of sisters in the Lord, and they didn't like to walk that much. So off I go to Cradle Mountain National Park. No idea, never been there before in my life. I didn't get opposite to you. Anyway, praise the Lord. I get on this trail, and it turns out it's the 8-day trail, and there's snow, and the snow was, yeah, it was quite high. It's right up to my thigh. And I just thought, this can't be good, and it was losing daylight, and I just sang a chorus I know the Lord will make a way for me. So then I thought, oh, there's a sign, so I go back. So I don't know, because I landed at this hut and I thought, oh, this cannot be good. I'm a fair way from the car park, I think. And praise the Lord, I got back, all was safe. And I did that again because I had the opportunity to go on that Canadian rally. And we went on Alaska tour, and you're on the cruise because it was, you know. So, you know, I have to go for another walk, and I go to the bush walk, and I thought if I don't get back in time on this bush walk, I mean, it's, you know, I have to pay for a flight to the next stop in Alaska. So, once again, had some prayer, praise the Lord, and there you go, found the trail back, because the signs weren't very clear at all, and the map this guy gave me on the cruise ship was not clear at all, because it's a bush walk. Can't use your Google Maps, I can tell you that. And praise the Lord, I found my way back. When I was working at that mental hospital, sorry.
No, you go for it.
2 seconds. When I was working at that hospital, I chopped off one of my fingers, and I knew what I'd done, exactly what I'd done. So I just covered my hand and I just started praying. And I didn't have any pain, went to the hospital, I sewed it up and all that sort of stuff. I said, also just below my nail. And there was no pain at all. And then I had to go back 6 weeks later to get rid of the stitches, take the stitches out, and that really hurt because I didn't pray about that. I thought that was just too cool. Leah had, she had tonsillitis. We didn't know about it. Took to the doctor. The doctor said, oh, she's got bad tonsillitis. And I thought, that, you know, but the Lord protected her from the pain. Abby had the same story as Hannah had. She wouldn't have made it into uni, but praise the Lord, she did. You know, we had prayer, and you know what? The Lord has done so much for me. I can't explain it all in this short time. It's comforting when my mum and dad passed away, and a sister who died from alcoholism. You know, it's just amazing. And thank you very much, New Zealand, for having us here.
Amen.